of the New York Times.
I think after 3 years, you can call me Mike.
You gonna give yourself a day off now?
I'm actually going into the office.
Come home soon.
I love you. This article was about saving young people's lives. You said write it up.
I said write it up, not make it up.
I did the best with what I had.
You have a future ahead of you, Mike, but not here.
You know, to be honest, I'm relieved it's over with the Times. You'd turn into a real prick working for them.
Hello?
Hi, I'm a reporter with the Oregonian. I wanted to get your side on the Christian Longo story.
Who?
He murdered his entire family.
Why are you telling me this?
Because when they apprehended him, he said he was Mike Finkel of the New York Times.
Did he say anything at all about why he claimed to be me?
I'd hoped you might be able to tell me that.
He was just a regular guy, an intelligent, sane man. He comes home one night and kills his wife and gets it. It makes no sense.
Thank you for seeing me, Mr. Longo.
Call me Chris.
So why me?
I followed your whole career. I guess I felt like I knew you. I want to tell you my side of this. Only you. Maybe at this point it doesn't matter.
The truth always matters.
It always seems to matter to you.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime story. Don't you see this as a second chance? You're an outcast.
That's not the man I wanted to be.
None of us is the man he wants to be.
Hello?
Jill, hey. It's nice to meet you.
Chris?
You know, Mike, he's been a real friend to me.
I just hope that we can be friends, too.
I believe we're dealing with an exceptionally dangerous man.
You had a choice of so many stories to tell, and you chose his.
Actually, he picked me.
He didn't pick you. He used you.
We think he's part of some bigger game plan.
This isn't just about me.
Who do you have to protect?
I can't say.
You think he's innocent, don't you?
My whole reputation's on the line.
Don't give up on me.
Are you really going to be the man who might set him free?
Will you stop?
Chris, did you do what you're accused of doing?